The news: members of parliament have moved to scrap the legacy of the former Speaker of Parliament, Rebecca Kadaga, by abolishing the Rebecca Alitwala Kadaga Institute of Parliamentary Studies. The Kilak North Member of Parliament, Anthony Akol, has been granted leave to Parliament to bring a private member's bill of amendment. Bring a private member's bill to amend the administration of Parliament Act to repeal the Kadaga Institute Act. We have the details.
Yesterday, Parliament granted leave to the Kilak North Member of Parliament, Anthony Akol, to bring a private member's bill to make amendments to the Administration of Parliament Act of 2020 to repeal the Rebecca Alitwala Kadaga Institute of Parliamentary Studies Act of 2020. In the move, which seems to be aiming at erasing the legacy of the former Speaker of Parliament, Rebecca Kadaga, the seconder of the move, Dan Kimosho, the Kazo County MP, says they want to reverse the institute's autonomy by taking it back to parliamentary service to improve its efficiency.
When we're looking at it, we're not looking at anyone as an individual. We're looking at issues in the law and purposing to achieve efficiency. Our view is that it should be mainstreamed with parliament. And I don't think anyone, I don't think any of the employees should be affected.
The Kadaga Institute was established by an Act of Parliament in 2020 as a semi-autonomous body with the objective of training members and the staff of Parliament plus other local government councils. But movers of the bill believe the institute's mandate is a duplication of other government institutes.
There is an institute, training institute, within Parliament that is a creature of the law and it has its own act. Yet it is fully resourced by the parliamentary commission. It has an executive director, and you're wondering, why can this work be done under the commission? And then, if there are any specialized trainings that must be done, can be done by the other government institutions that are established in the law to exactly do the training.
Kimosho adds that the Kadaga Institute has been so consumptive to parliamentary coffers, yet it doesn't generate its own resources.
Even when we get people from other countries and they want to train here, the way it was framed, it is the government of Uganda that must resource the training. The trainees, in that matter, do not pay any money. So we are saying, let's do away with the training institute. The parliamentary commission have a department which looks at training needs.
The bill also seeks to rename the institute from the Rebecca Alitwala Kadaga Institute of Parliamentary Studies into the Institute of Parliamentary Studies as it was before.
Some of these institutions should not also be personalized, really. You don't say it's because it is A or X or Y, Z, no. It is about the efficiency, it's about the principle, it's not about anyone. And I cannot be part of the group that sets out either to chant, delete, or amend anyone in terms of personality.
The amendments could also see the Deputy Speaker, a member of the Parliamentary Commission, as currently the Deputy Speaker only attends by the virtue of Speaker, allowing him or her to take part.
The Administration of Parliament Act. The Deputy Speaker is not clearly brought out as a member of the Commission. And being that she is the second in line of command, or it can be she or he at any time, I think it is very important that it is clear in the law that a deputy speaker is a member of the parliamentary commission.
Story by Fred Kajubi for the news.